Since you're here, I'm assuming you already know what a great tool Canva is. However, if you are like most users, you're probably underutilizing the tools that Canva has to offer. And so I want this to be part one, maybe two. I feel like I might have done a video like this before. Either way, this is gonna be our part in our Canva apps series, where we're gonna go through all the apps, or at least my favorite apps in Canva and how you can use them. Today specifically, we're gonna be looking at apps that have to do with type. Because if you're like me and a lot of other users, you do a pretty bland type. But there are apps out there that can do different fonts and different font effects and all kinds of stuff. So let me take you through five different Canva apps that can launch your typefaces and your graphics and your overlays and all your cool stuff to a whole nother level. Let's get into it. First thing we're gonna do is go to canva.com. If you don't already have an account, go ahead and create an account. And if you don't have Canva Pro, hop down in the description where there will be a 30-day Canva Pro free trial for you to utilize and make all sorts of cool stuff. But first thing we're gonna do is we're just going to create a design. There is actually a spot over here under apps that you can click on and you can go to. And you can see that there are plenty of apps here. And if you were to click one, it'll ask you if you wanna open it in a new design or use an existing one. For simplicity's sake, we're gonna go ahead and create a new design. I am just gonna go with something custom. We're just gonna go 1500 by 800, right? Create a new design. Now that our design is opened up, we can actually go right over here to apps. First app we're gonna look at is an app called Type Extrude. But if you're curious where your apps are, you can always click right here and it'll show you all your apps. This is the one we're gonna be using. But if you wanna find new apps, you can click on Discover. There'll be some trending apps, different kind of categories you can select, the popular apps, you can kind of click through and see different ones, right? That one actually looks pretty cool. Maybe it'll be in next month's video. Then there's AI powered, but you can also go here and sort by just create something. And this will show you a lot of like your type, your different ones. There's also, of course, your AI powered, and there is a boatload of AI powered apps. But for now, we're gonna go ahead and type in Type Extrude, just like that. That's the one we're looking for. And as it sounds like, this can extrude text. And so you can type in your own text here. Like say I wanted to write subscribe. I can go under font. I can change the font out. I've played with a lot of these fonts and they all look pretty good. You can see it right there. I'm going with permanent marker. I'm gonna stick with the font that it gave me, the Patea, that one. And then here, of course, we can change our colors. We could have the inside, you know, this blue and the outside red. You know, if we want to create something that looks absolutely hideous, we could do that. I'm sorry if that is your brand colors. I'm gonna go with white. I'm gonna go with like a purple. You know, my brand color would be a little bit darker, but it's fine. I'm not gonna worry about it. If I had my Dr. Hill's brand here, this would be all my brands. That is my church brand. So anyway, I guess we can go with that. Let's go with our blue and that kind of light blue on the inside, right? I can make the outline thicker and kind of see it happening. I make the outline thinner, kind of like it right about where it was. I can change my angle and kind of look up here and see everything that's happening. I can change the angle of the extrusion. Again, I kind of liked it how it was. I thought the settings were pretty good. I can change the length so you can see how it's like coming way off, which is a really cool effect, honestly. We could actually, let's go with like that long extrusion real quick. Click add to design. Then I have something like this. Then I could always go, but this is something that you can't do with Canva natively. I'm gonna reduce that extrude length in just for the sake of this document that I'm working on, something like that. And then we're just gonna click update and there we go. So that is Type Extrude to start off with. That one is pretty cool. You can do a lot of cool stuff with it. So let's go back to our apps right here and go for our next one, which is going to be Type Gradient. Now this, I actually have a tutorial, I think it's a short, on how to do this through like a backdoor way. You gotta like export the image and bring it back in. Anyway, lots of weird stuff. Now there is an app that simply does it. And so it's exactly what it sounds like. You can put in any type you want. Then you can go here and you can change, right? You can change your gradient color. So let's say I wanna do like this orange color to more like a yellow, lighter type yellow, orange, you know. I can go here, then I can actually adjust my points. So maybe I want an orange over here and more yellow here. You know, I can change out the font, of course, to you know, anything I want. Let's go with this one. I don't know why. Yeah, so I can do something like that. And once I'm ready, I can just click add to design and there it is. There is my word with the type gradient on it, right? Pretty simple to use, but it's actually a feature that we've been wanting for a long time. And here it is in app form. All right, next up is gonna be type warp. Type warp, it's this one right here. And kind of as it says, it warps the text, does some cool effects with it. So let's just stick to our word subscribe. Of course, we can go in here, change out our font to anything we want. Let's just find something. And there's a lot of fonts. Okay, let's just go back with Anton. Right, so I can have kind of this shape. I can do it to the lower side if I wanted. I can go through like these different waves. I can adjust the height of it, right? I can do this actual like wave effect, sort of like that. That's pretty cool. We can go to like left or right. Right, we can do it different ways. I really like this. Oh, this one right here. I think that's a really cool effect. Of course, we can come in here, change the font color to whatever we want it to be. We can adjust how many waves are in it and kind of see how it's doing all sorts of crazy stuff. We'll go kind of medium. We can adjust the height if we want to go really crazy. Let's just go kind of subtle here. Something like that. Perfect. Now we have, you know, a nice just like that, right? All right, we'll create a new page for the next ones. All right, so that is type warp, just a few different kind of warps and things you can do on there that all come out looking pretty good. Next is gonna be one called Text Art Maker. Yep, this one right here. Now this one's really interesting, I will say. So I can type in, you know, whatever my word is, and then I'm gonna choose a file. Now I didn't have anything like selected or that I'd thought about, but I did have the Twitch logo on here, right here. And I chose the Twitch logo. Now you can go and choose any kind of vector image or any kind of like PNG file. I mean, you can, I'm using the Twitch logo. You could do like Spotify, you could do puzzle pieces, just anything you want. You could actually go and make one in Canva, export it out and then bring it back in. Then I can adjust the density. I like it a little bit lower density so you can actually tell what it is. I'm gonna go and adjust my max size to like 3 and my minimum size to like 0.2 just to give some depth there. And then if I add it to the design, you'll see, it's hard to see right here, but if I make it larger, that the whole word is actually made up of just little bitty Twitch logos. And so you can kind of imagine you could do that with anything, whether it fits your branding. Like I could see me doing it with like the little plus, like green plus signs or something, like the little healing icons, and creating different words, different things, just, you know, cool stuff to go crazy with, right? All right, so that is Text Art Maker. Pretty simple, be fun to play around with. All right, the last one that we're gonna look at today, go back over here to apps. The last one we mess with today is called Motion Type. And it's this one right here. There's two. I don't know if they're different, but I'm just gonna go to that one. For right now, all there are 5 templates, but still some cool stuff. So let's go like this outline effect. I thought this one looked really cool. Type in, of course, subscribe, right? Change our font to, you know, whatever we want it to be. Let's see. Let's go with Pacifico. Yeah, that one's cool. We can change the text color. We'll just stick to our church. Oh, I guess we won't. We'll go with like a blue. And then we'll make these like an orange, go with some nice Florida Gator colors, right? Something like that. Hey, I was actually pretty close to the Florida Gator colors for just guessing. I can bump my repetition. So let's go to like 8. Okay, that's kind of cool. I can go duration. Let's see, let's go all the way up to 5. Okay, a little too slow. Let's go back to 2. That's cool. Okay, now all I gotta do is add to design. Now this one takes a couple minutes because it is generating out a motion video, right, that it's going to put on here. So take just a moment. So there we go, right in my videos here. So I had to go under uploads over to videos and I found it right there. It is now, it's kind of cut off, which is, you know, a little bit annoying, but either way we can play with it. You know, there we go, make it full screen. You'll never know, but it looks like, if I'm not mistaken, it is actually on a transparent background, which is nice. Yeah, look at that. So even on a transparent background, so we could use this anywhere. We could use this in our overlays. We could use this on stream in different videos, things like that. But yeah. But hey, there is our 5 apps for us to use in Canva. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you subscribe to the channel. And with that, I'll see you in the next one.